Hey everybody, this is one of the other videos that I'm pre-filming, and this is going to be my book video. This is one of my favorite topics to talk about, so I'm not going to go over every single book that I'm going to read or that I've read recently, because there are just too many. I have a pile of books that need to be read that is like sky high, so I'll probably do more than one of these videos, and as I read them, I will talk about them later, you know, so, these are books that I've either bought, were given to me for gifts from people at work, or my brother, or friends, books I've bought, books that were gifts, or books that I'm trading with people that I work with, because we kind of, you know, I work in retail, and it's like our only outlet is we read, so, that's what's happening. I'm reading a series of books that I'm sharing with somebody at work. They're actually my copies of the books. They're not hers. So I read one and she gets that copy of it. And then I move on to the next book in line. So she's a book behind me, but that's fine. And it is probably a very popular book series. It is the Sookie Stackhouse series. I got into True Blood, the TV show, probably after, I don't even know, I've had HBO for over 2 years, and it's probably the 2 years that True Blood was on, and I just never watched. And for whatever reason, over the summer, I decided I was going to give it a shot. So what I did was, I went out and I bought the first 2 seasons. And I wanted to be done with the first 2 seasons and all caught up with what had happened in season 3 by the time the next episode came on. So I had a True Blood binge. I watched both season 1 and season 2 and half of season 3, and I caught up in time for the next episode. And then once season 3 was over, I needed my True Blood fix, so I went and I bought the books. I got them from Amazon for a lot cheaper than they sell them on Barnes & Noble. So I got the box set of 8, and then I bought the 9th one. And since I have all 8 in paperback, or all 9 in paperback, I'm waiting for the 10th one to come out in paperback, so I'm not going to get the 10th one yet. But I'm on the 7th one. I'm reading this one pretty quickly, actually. I started it the other day, and I'm halfway through. So my friend has the 6th one. I'm not going to show you all of them. They're by Charlene Harris, if you haven't read them. I think they're great. They're vastly different from the series. Like, in this book, and I don't want to give too much away, but Russell isn't dating, can't think of his name now. Talbot. Russell's not with Talbot. He's with the King of Indiana. And they're getting married. And so it's a lot different. It's a lot different. Of course, this is the 7th book, so lots happened since that whole incident would have happened if they were following the books exactly. So maybe there's something different. I don't know. But they did keep Russell being gay. Or preferring men, I should say, in the series. So that's fine. I can't wait for season 4 to see if they pick up stuff from the 3rd book or the 4th book. It'll be very interesting to see. Now, let's see. A book that I've actually read and finished is this one called My Journey with Farrah, A Story of Life, Love, and Friendship by Alana Stewart. I was a Farrah Fawcett fan. And this book came out after she died. It's a diary that Alana wrote the entire time that Farrah was going through her cancer thing and her battle with cancer and up until the day she died. Actually, probably before the day she died, because at the end it says Farrah Fawcett passed away on June 25th, 2009. This book was so good. It was so good. I loved it, and I just, it was heart-wrenching, and it was uplifting, and it makes me want to cry thinking about it, actually. So I'm going to stop talking about it, but if you want more insight into what happened, to see how strong this woman was, I would definitely recommend this book. And I like it because it's written like a diary, so you can stop on an entry and you don't have to worry about what page you're on. You just have to worry about what entry you read. Okay, so that's that one. Now, a few that I have borrowed from work. Wolfman. I didn't see the movie. I did watch the movie. Sorry. I saw the movie for this one before I'm reading the book. I have not started the book, so I cannot tell you how it's going to be. But I'm kind of excited to read it. I mean, it kind of goes along with my True Blood thing. I like Alcide, so... Werewolves, vampires. I did not read the Twilight series, so please don't ask. I am not interested in sparkling vampires. That is not my thing. This one is another one I borrowed, Shutter Island. I'm sure everybody has read this book. I have not seen the movie. I will likely read the book before I see the movie. So we'll see. And this one is called... It's actually got my name on it. Because somebody at work wanted me and two other people to read. So it's called The Bone Man's Daughters by Ted Decker. I've never heard of this author before. And I'm not even sure what the book is about. It says, "Would you kill an innocent man to save your daughter?" They call him Bone Man, a serial killer who's abducted 6 young women. He's the perfect father looking for the perfect daughter, and his victims fail to meet his lofty expectations. He kills them by breaking their bones and leaving them to die. Interesting. Okay, so... this, and on the front it says, it does get under your skin, it crawls there and nests and raises its head with a bitter tug like it's living with you. Which is... what Brad Meltzer from the New York Times bestselling author of The Book of Lies said. So we'll see how that is. I like books that grab me, so we'll see. I hope it does. I hope it does. This one I picked up while I was in Philadelphia on my way home from the Poconos in June of 2010. It's The Kid Who Climbed Everest by Bear Grylls. Bear Grylls, I love Bear Grylls, he's, Man vs. Wild, and, what is it, Worst Case Scenario, or something like that. So, I'm kind of interested to see, because he was the first 23-year-old to summit, to reach the summit of Mount Everest. So we'll see. Because I did watch Expedition Everest or whatever it was called, and those people went through hell, so... kind of interested to read that. I don't know why. I like true stories, but at the same time I like books like Shutter Island and Wolfman. This one I'm currently reading. I stopped reading it to read the True Blood series. This is Lessons in Becoming Myself by Ellen Burstyn. She's one of my favorite actresses. So I was enjoying this book immensely, and I put it down so I could pick up the True Blood series, and I haven't read anything else since the True Blood series. And the last one that I just recently got is called The Art of Racing in the Rain by Garth Stein. I want to read this so bad. I'm actually thinking of reading it while I'm reading the True Blood books, but I'm kind of holding off so I can put all my attention on one thing. When I read more than one book at a time, it tends to be kind of crazy. So that's that for now. I will have plenty more of these book videos to upload and share with you, and I will let you know how the rest of them go, which ones I read next, and all of that fun stuff. So I'm going to go get back to my Sookie Stackhouse book, Altogether Dead, and I will talk to you in my next video. Bye.